Hello everyone, welcome to this new video on belt drive numerical problems. In this video, I will solve some belt drive numerical problems using the formula explained in the previous video. So before watching this video, watch the previous video to understand the equations. Before solving the problem, I would like to tell about notations used in the derivations and problems. Radius of driver pulley and radius of driven pulley are represented as capital letter R and small letter r respectively in derivation. They can be replaced with R1 and R2 also while solving the problems. We'll start with first problem. Find out length of open belt drive if the radius of larger pulley is 3 times the smaller pulley and the distance between the centers is 95 mm. Diameter of smaller pulley is 22.5 mm. First, we'll take down all the given data. So start with capital letter R is equal to 3R. Capital letter R is driver pulley radius. Small letter r is driven pulley radius. And L is equal to 95 mm is the center to center distance. Small letter D is 22.5 mm. So divided by 2 is radius of the driven pulley, which is 11.25 mm. So from the first equation we can find out capital letter R has 33.75 mm. We know the equation to find out length of open belt drive has L is equal to 2L plus R minus R whole square divided by L plus pi into R plus R. Now substitute all the values in this equation. 2 into 95 plus 33.75 minus 11.25 whole square divided by 95 plus pi into 33.75 plus 11.25. Calculate this by using the calculator and we'll get the answer as 336.69 mm. We'll move on to next problem, and in this problem it is given as an engine is driving a generator by means of a belt. The pulley on the driving shaft has a diameter of 55 cm and runs at 276 rpm. If the radius of the pulley on the generator is 15 cm, find the speed in rpm. So in this case, diameter of the driving shaft is given along with its speed n1. Whereas diameter of the driven pulley is given, we need to find out speed of that in RPM. So we start with taking down all the data here. So D1, which is diameter of the driver pulley, is 55 cm and its corresponding speed is N1, which is 276 RPM. Driven pulley radius is given as R2 is equal to 15 cm. From this we can find out its diameter by multiplying 2, which is 30 cm. We need to find out its speed in RPM, that is N2. So N1 by N2 is equal to D2 by D1 is the equation. Substitute all the values in this equation. 276 divided by N2 is equal to 30 divided by 55. After calculating, we'll get N2 has 506 rpm. Now we'll move on to next problem, and in this problem 3, a shaft is running at 100 rpm is to drive a parallel shaft at 150 rpm. The pulley on the driving shaft is 35 cm in diameter. Find the diameter of driven pulley. Calculate the velocity ratio. In this case, speed of both driving pulley and driven pulley is given in RPM. Also, driving shaft diameter is given as 35 cm. We need to find out diameter of driven pulley, that is D2. So we start with taking down all the data. So N1 is equal to 100 RPM and N2 is equal to 150 RPM corresponding to driver and driven pulley respectively. D1 is given as 35 cm is also equal to 350 mm. D2A is unknown. Velocity ratio is how much? We use the equation N1 by N2 is equal to D2 by D1. So N1 is 100 rpm and N2 is 150 rpm, that is equal to D2, which is unknown, and D1 is 350 mm. After calculating, we'll get D2 has 233.3 mm. In order to find out the velocity ratio, equation is N1 by N2. That is equal to 100 divided by 150 is equal to 0.66. Velocity ratio value is always less than 1. Next, we'll move on to fourth problem. In an open belt drive running in clockwise direction, the tension in tight side is 3000 newton and the arc of contact is 150 degree. If the coefficient of friction is 0.3, find the tension on the slack side of the belt. Here tension on the tight side is capital letter T1, whereas tension on the slack side is capital letter T2. Arc of contact is nothing but the angle of contact, that is theta, 150 degree. We need to convert this 150 degree into radians while substituting. The coefficient of friction is nothing but mu value, which is given as 0.3. So we start with given data, T1 is equal to 3000 newton and theta is 150 degree. Mu is given as 0.3. We need to find out T2 value. Equation to find out this is log of T1 by T2 is equal to 0.4343 mu theta. So on the right hand side, 0.4343 into mu value is 0.3 and theta is 150 degree. Convert that to radians by multiplying pike and dividing it by 180. So theta value in radians is 2.61. On the left side, log of T1 by T2 as it is. Now substitute T1 value has 3000 newtons and T2 as it is. On the right hand side, if you calculate, we'll get 0.34. So I'll take log to the right hand side and it becomes e raised to 0.34. On the left hand side, it is 3000 divided by T2. So on simplifying this, we'll get the value of T2 as 1376.14 newtons. Next, we'll move on to fifth problem. A flat open belt drive consists of pulley of diameter 1000 mm. and 500 mm with a center distance of 1500 mm. Coefficient of friction between the pulley and the belt is 0.3. When the maximum tension in the belt is 700 newton, find the effective pull of the belt drive. Effective pull is nothing but the difference between the tensions T1 and T2. Maximum tension is given as 700 newton, which is nothing but T1. So we start with taking down all the data. So capital letter D1 is equal to 1000 mm, so divide it by 2, we'll get the radius of driving pulley as capital letter R or R1. Similarly, D2 is 500 mm, divide it by 2, we'll get radius R2 or R, which is 250 mm. So center distance is given as 1500 mm, mu is given as 0.3, T1 is given as 700 newton. We need to find out T2, also we need to find out effective pull T1 minus T2. In order to find out T2, we use the equation log T1 by T2 is equal to 0.4343 mu theta. What is the value of theta? Since theta value is not directly given, we need to find out theta by using the equation 180 minus 2 alpha, and alpha is equal to sine inverse of capital letter R minus small letter r into L. Substitute the values. So sine inverse of 500 minus 250 divided by 1500. So alpha value in degree is 9.6 degrees. So theta is equal to 180 minus 2 into 9.6 degrees, and that is equal to 160.82 degrees. We need to convert this degrees into radians. So multiply pi and divide it by is equal to 2.8 radians. Now log of T1 by T2 is equal to 0.4343 into 0.3 into 2.8. So substitute all the values on the left side. Substitute T1 value has 700 Newton on the left side and simplify, you will get the answer has 305 into 67 Newtons on the slack side. So effective pull is 700 minus 305.67 is equal to 394.33 Newtons.